Yo, what's up guys? It's Jeff from Updated, and today we are taking a look at some of the new privacy settings you need to take advantage of in iOS 15. So get your iDevices with iOS 15 installed onto them, and let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so first up, we are going to be checking out some of the data sharing toggles you can turn off if you don't want the data from your device to be shared with other people. Now, to do this, head into the Settings app, then go into the Privacy menu. Now, in this menu, scroll down to the very bottom and look for the menu option called Analytics and Improvements. Now, go into that menu, and here you will see a bunch of toggles for data sharing features and where they are going. Now, I personally just toggled off the first option, which turns off all data sharing completely, but you can go down the very long list and select your own options should you want to still leave some of them on and share some of that data with Apple or other partners of theirs. Now, next up is a Safari setting that enables you to hide your IP address when browsing. To use this feature, go into the Settings app, then head into the Safari menu. That menu is about halfway down when you first enter the Settings app. Now, once in that menu, go about 3/4 of the way down and you will find the privacy and security section in this menu. And you want to look for the hide IP address option. Now, you can go into that specific menu and select your preferences, but I personally hide my IP address from trackers and websites just to ensure I'm most private when browsing. Okay, so the next setting has to do with mail privacy and how you use the Apple Mail app. Enabling privacy protection for your mail app will stop people from knowing when you open your mail and what you are doing with your mail by hiding your IP address and blocking trackers that send back data on read statuses of emails. Now, to do this, open up the Settings app, then go down to the Mail menu, which is in the same section of the Safari menu. Now, once in the Mail menu, go down to the Messages section and you'll find a menu called Privacy Protection. Now, in this menu, you'll have the option to enable or disable the abilities I just went over. And of course, you can turn this on or off at any time with zero effect on your inbox. Now, the next two features do require a subscription to iCloud Plus, but I would highly recommend that you do get that subscription just to enable these two very important features. So the first is also email related, and it's called Hide My Email. To access this feature, go into the iCloud menu in the Settings app, and from here, go down to the menu option called Hide My Email. In this menu, you'll be able to create essentially dummy email addresses that you can give to websites and apps that could potentially send you junk mail, and they will forward all of this mail to a normal email. Now, this will allow you to remain anonymous to the people you don't want knowing your real email address. So that's very important because there's a lot of people out there that you don't want to have that contact that may sell your data. So you can actually provide them with a fake email and then they won't have your real email to sell to others or to give to others through like mailing list or anything like that. Now, the last and final feature is iCloud Private Relay, which can also be found in the iCloud menu as well. Now, when you enable this feature, the Safari data you use on your phone will go through Apple's own servers, which will hide your IP address and browsing activity from the internet and also from Apple. Now, this will do things like stop websites and businesses from tracking your browsing activity and sending you targeted ads. It will keep your IP address private from those who intend to try to cyber attack you. And it will also protect your critical information like credit and debit cards as you make purchases online. Now, very quickly, one extra feature I wanted to show you is what's called a privacy report. And you can generate one by going into the Settings app, then going on to the privacy menu. Now, at the very bottom of this menu, there's an option called Record App Activity. And here you can turn on this feature to record your app activity and how your apps use your data for 7 days. Your phone will essentially generate a report and you can see data on how apps use your microphone, location, and how they track your activity on the internet as well. So guys, those were a few of the new privacy features in iOS 15. And of course, if you have any questions about today's video, you can leave those in the comment section down below. But yeah, We hope to see you in some future iOS 15 content, but until then, make sure you check out some of these awesome privacy features in today's video. Hey guys, thanks for watching today's video on the updated YouTube channel. Before you head out, make sure to get subscribed and also hit that notification bell button to stay up to date for when we publish any new content here on the channel. Also, if you want to check out some other things that we have going on, check the channel information link down below. It's solo.to/updated. You can check out our channel memberships, our merch store, my personal Twitter account, which you should totally follow, and a link to the updated podcast where we have new episodes every single week. That podcast is called The Infinite Loop, and we talk about everything going on in the world of tech. Also, we have links to our giveaways sponsored by awesome companies like Privado VPN, so definitely check those out as well. We'll have a new one every single month. So guys, thank you again for watching today's video, and we hope to see you guys in some upcoming content. But until then, I hope you all have an awesome day.